Blackgate Penitentiary. Harley Quinn, the psychiatrist turned felon and frequent rival of Batman, was reportedly seen at Blackgate during the riot, despite the fact that she is not currently an inmate. According to sources within Blackgate, Quinn had been quietly using the safety of a cell as a kind of base of operations, enabled by some well-placed allies within prison security. Authorities are now looking into whether Quinn incited the riot and what motive she could have possibly had to do so. I'm Noor Rashid, and this is GCN.
Penguin wouldn't talk. I don't have the same sway here I had back in Bloodhaven.
You may be surprised to learn Batman struggled with similar challenges early in his career. So for a time, he focused his energies elsewhere in the city. When word of his work got out, people were more inclined to cooperate.
The city. We've been so caught up in Batman's last case, we haven't been paying attention to the rest of Gotham.
Gotham may not know Batman is gone, but it certainly feels his absence. There has been a marked increase in gang-related crime.
Plus Penguin's own businesses. Maybe if we pay those a visit, take care of a few of the crimes, he'll be ready to talk.
You've also received messages from Lucius Fox and Detective Montoya. They may be able to help.
Thanks, Alfred. Batman's gonna be a tough act to follow.
You never were one for stage fright. An encrypted message from Fox Tekka.
Sorry I've been a ghost since the funeral, but I just realized I forgot to send flowers. If you're ever in the neighborhood, let's meet in my building. I'd like to give you them in person.
Lucius Fox wants to give us flowers. Does he know couriers exist?
Knowing Lucius, I suspect he has something far more useful for us. When you reach Fox Tekka, head straight to the roof.
Hey, Babs, I've noticed you take your brace off before going on patrol. Do you need us to modify your suit?
Oh, that's okay. I actually built in some bracing mods myself.
Oh, wow. That's so cool.
At this stage, my physio, Gail, doesn't want me wearing the brace 24/7, but she doesn't,
Know what you do for a living?
Exactly. So, I incorporated some of my own assistive tech. You know, new courses are starting soon at Gotham Public Library.
That's where you used to work, right?
Yep. They've got adult courses in the afternoon. Stuff like watercolor painting, mineralogy, foreign languages.
So you're saying I need a hobby? Got it.
Maybe a little. I mean, I know you read and work on your bike and weapons, but how's about doing something outside the Belfry?
That's what works for. What?
I was just thinking of that time we all made dinner together, and Tim got tomato sauce over Bruce and Babs.
I don't remember that.
What? No, you have to. It was the same year. You know what? Never mind. Dumb story anyway.
Well, I could tell you a story. It's about being dead, then brought back to life by a pit of mind-altering goo.
Hey, I didn't mean that.
I don't know what's worse. Having a chunk of my life taken away from me, or coming back to everyone thinking I'm gonna snap.
I'm sorry, Jason. We shouldn't have... I shouldn't have treated you like an outsider.
My God, you're such a Boy Scout. No wonder you were the first. So, you really believe the Chupacabra and the Kraken and all that stuff are real?
Yep.
And what about the Loch Ness Monster?
Clayface and Killer Croc totally exist, but Nessie is too far-fetched for you?
Fair enough. Gotham must feel like a cryptid gold mine to you.
You have no idea.
I miss Ace. He's the best dog.
Master Bruce wanted to name him Bat-Hound at first.
Of course he did. He wasn't the best at anything.
No, he was not. But thankfully, I talked him out of it.
Can you ask Julia to give Ace a good belly rub for me?
It'd be my pleasure.
How long did it take you to find this secret room in the upstairs hallway?
Playing with a ghost, Alfred?
You might say that. I'm finishing my last game with Bruce. I couldn't save our board from the manor, but I do have our notes. We tracked each move. To continue the game, if one of us was ever away.
Are you winning?
Playing as Bruce, I can't see how he loses.
Bruce is dead. Maybe he wins your game, but without him, we've lost.
I'm not so sure about that.
Not so sure he's dead?
Not so sure we've lost. Bruce played an important role. But he never saw himself as the only piece in play.
Yeah!
That was embarrassing.
Get it now!
Get it now! I'm gonna kill you!
We're coming in!
Great!
That's not good. Belfry, I've got wounded out here. Call an ambulance.
We have paramedics coming shortly.
Stuff's gotta be good. It's all over pictograph.
Thank you.
lost me!
Gave me a heart attack.
Red Hood.
Not the person I expected to meet, but I suppose Batman trusts you.
You're in his good books too, so I guess we'll be working together. What's happening?
Well, since we lost Gordon, some cops are back to playing dirty again. Kane doesn't like it, but she's not doing much to stop it either.
Corruption in the GCPD? You don't say.
I know Batman was helping Gordon clean up the force. But now any cops who used to be on Gordon's team are getting their asses handed to them. The gangs are ambushing them because they won't take bribes, and dispatchers are giving them the worst assignments because they make trouble for everyone else.
And it keeps going on until only the worst cops are left. Yeah, I get the picture.
Look, I hate to ask, but can you keep an eye on cops when they're facing off against the gangs? I know a lot of my fellow officers have issues with vigilantes, but they need the help.
It's fine. If it helps clean up the force, I'm in.
Thanks. I'll try to get you some resources to help you protect everyone in Gotham, not just us.
I'll see what I can do.
You're the number one water cooler topic down at the precinct. Keep up the good work. Nice job out there. Thanks for the help out there.
See anything interesting, Fox?
You trying to give me another heart attack? Batman taught you everything, huh?
Hey, I taught him a few things, too. Though he was better at watching Gotham. Even when I was trying to take out the gangs, I couldn't stay a step ahead of them like he could.
You're getting there. The bat doesn't fall far from the belfry. From what I've seen, anyway.
Thanks.
Don't thank me yet. Mentor and I always knew that something like this could happen. When I left Wayne Tech, we kept some research going. There are a lot of eyes on you now. No one's looking at Fox Tech. As long as I got a breath between the gills, you'll still have everything you need to carry on Batman's legacy. Speaking of which...
You can bring me flowers anytime.
It's Luke's design. A custom bird to help you get around a little quicker. Hefty enough to support exactly one hero.
Hello, beautiful. Care to show me around Gotham?
Now you can thank me.
Thanks, Fox.
Over here!
I'm ready to take her out for a spin, Fox. How do I start?
You're getting ahead of yourself. Before you can use the bird, you'll have to clear a path for it.
I knew there'd be a catch.
Lately, the GCPD's not content to have jackboots on the ground. They've launched a network of surveillance drones to patrol the skies. If they're looking for you when you try to get airborne...
I'll be grounded. Got it. So, what's the plan?
A creative programmer could convince those drones to overlook certain targets. But for that to work, close-up scans would be required.
So if I do the legwork, you'll give me a VIP pass. Nice.
The cops have the city divided into sectors, with a set of drones watching over each one. Until you scan all the drones in a sector, consider it a no-fly zone.
No flying until we take care of the surveillance drones. Got it.
I'll send you the location of the first one so you can get to work.